Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Joy C. Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about the RBI's Central Board of Directors. Let us first see what is the current affair associated with RBI's Central Board of Directors. The RBI Governor Mr. Urjit Patel has convened a meeting of the RBI's Central Board of Directors and this meeting is aimed at discussing various issues that is going on. There is an ongoing debate or tussle between the RBI, that is the Reserve Bank of India, which is the monetary authority of the country, as well as the government. So both RBI and the government is involved in a tussle. And therefore, the meeting of the RBI Central Board of Directors is important. And also, we should be able to detail the roles and functions of the Central Board of Directors. So, in this lecture, we will be discussing about the Central Board of Directors in detail. Now, for those who doesn't know about the ongoing tussle between RBI and the government, I have made a lecture on the issues between RBI and the government. You can find it on StudyIQ channel or on my Facebook page. So, you will be able to know more about the ongoing debate between RBI and the government and also to know more about Section 7 of the RBI Act, which is a very important current affair, you can again refer to StudyIQ channel or my Facebook page to get the details of Section 7 of the RBI Act. I have made a lecture on that too. Now let us move on to our topic. Let us first understand the general mandate of the board. The Central Board of Directors is appointed by the government. So the government appoints the Central Board of Directors in accordance with the RBI Act of 1934. So, the RBI Act of 1934 has the provisions for the Central Board of Directors. Now, regarding the strength of the board, the full strength of the board is 21 and this will include the Governor of RBI plus a maximum of 4 Deputy Governors of the RBI. And regarding the meeting of this board, the board is required to meet at least 6 times in a year and it should be at least once in every quarter. So, in a financial year, there are 4 quarters, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. It is mandatory that the board should meet at least once in a quarter and minimum 6 times in a year. The board generally meets in Delhi at least once when the finance minister addresses the full board. And this is usually after presenting the budget for the coming year. And in this meeting, the finance minister will outline the government's economic philosophy behind the policy initiatives proposed. So, under the budget, the government would have proposed certain policies. And in the meeting, the finance minister will be outlining the economic philosophy of the government. Besides Delhi and Mumbai, Mumbai is where RBI is headquartered. The board generally meets at various state capitals because in most of the state capitals, there are branches of the RBI. Now, regarding the decision taken in the board, the governor seeks the advice of the board before taking a decision. But finally, it is the decision of the governor before taking a decision. And with regard to the interest rates, it is a monetary policy committee which is the deciding authority. And according to the RBI Act, the deputy governors and also the government nominees, they can attend any or all of the meetings of the central board. So, deputy governors as well as the government nominees can opt to attend any or all of the meetings of the board. But they are not entitled to vote. And in case of event of a equality of vote, according to the RBI Act, the governor has a casting vote or a second vote. Now, let us look at the current composition of the board. At present, the central board has 18 members, including 5 official directors. And these 5 official directors are, one is the governor and 4 deputy governors. So, these 5 are the official directors of the board. Including these 5 official directors, the strength of the board is 18 members. And the government nominees, they are, one is the Economic Affairs Secretary and the second one is Financial Services Secretary. So, these 2 are the government nominees in the board. And there are also 4 directors representing the local boards, that is, 1 director from each region. So, altogether 4 directors who represent the local boards. And there are also 7 more directors who are appointed by the government. And this 4 plus 7 directors, they are part-time directors. And they are also non-official directors. So, official directors we have already seen. There are 5 official directors, which includes the RBI governor as well as 4 deputy governors. So, this 4 plus 7, 11 directors are non-official and part-time directors. Now, let us see how these members are appointed in the board. There is no prescribed list for the government in order to follow while making a decision about nominating someone to the board. So, we have seen there are 7 plus 4, 11 part-time non-official directors. So, this non-official directors are chosen by the political executive. And what is the process for this nomination? The proposal for the appointment to the central board is moved by the Department of Financial Services. And the Department of Financial Services comes under the Finance Ministry. Now, this proposal which is moved by the Department of Financial Services has to be approved by the ACC. ACC is the Appointments Committee of the Cabinet. So, this is the procedure by which government nominates non-official part-time directors to the board. Now, let us understand what are the key functions of the board. The committee of the central board. The committee meets every week and they basically reviews the statistics in RBI's weekly bulletin. And there are various subcommittees, and 2 important subcommittees are, one is BFS, that is Board for Financial Supervision, and the second one is BPSS, that is Board for Payment and Settlement Systems. These 2 are the important committees, and these 2 committees are chaired by the governor. Let us see what is BFS, that is Board for Financial Supervision. The Board for Financial Supervision meets every month. So, their meeting is conducted every month on a monthly basis. And this Board for Financial Supervision includes the deputy governors as ex officio members and also 4 other directors. So, deputy governors are the ex officio members, and there are in addition 4 directors in this board. The purpose of this board is to undertake the supervision of banks, financial institutions, NBFCs, etc. That means the supervision of financial system, banks, financial institutions, NBFCs, are done by this committee. Now, the second important committee is the Board for Payment and Settlement System, or BPSS. Now, what is the function of BPSS? It takes care of the paper-based and electronic systems like National Electronic Funds Transfer or RTGS, Real-Time Gross Settlement, etc. So, these 2 are the 2 important committees, and there are various other subcommittees like Subcommittee on Information Technology, on Audit, on Risk Management, on Human Resource Management, etc. So, various subcommittees are there, and the key committees are BFS and BPSS. Now, let us see whether the board has an overriding or superior power. What is the power of the board? This question, whether the board has a superior power or overriding power, is relevant because the government has already invoked Section 7 of the RBI Act. So, we have already made a lecture on Section 7 of the RBI Act. If you are not aware of the facts regarding Section 7 of the RBI Act, please refer to my video on Section 7 of RBI Act, which is available on the StudyIQ channel and also on my Facebook page. Now, briefly, under Section 7, government has sought consultation with the governor on certain issues it considers necessary in the public interest. And that is the provision of Section 7 of the RBI Act. That is, the government can consult the governor on certain issues which the government considers is important regarding the public interest. Now, under this Section 7, there are 2 subsections. The first one is that the board has the responsibility to superintend and generally look after the affairs of the bank. So, the affairs of the RBI, central bank, will be taken care by the board. And the second provision, or the second subsection, is that it is subject to regulations which the board may provide. The governor, or in his absence, any deputy governor which the governor has appointed, has the same powers. That means according to the section 7, the two subsections, both this, one is the board and secondly the governor of the RBI. Both this has the powers to superintend and look after the affairs of the bank. So it is not clear whether the board is dominating or whether the governor of the RBI is dominating. So according to the section, the board can give certain directions to the governor but subject to regulations in accordance with the act. Now, what are these regulations? The regulations are clearly mentioned in section 58. That is, the section 58 of the RBI Act clearly says how or what is the process for invoking such regulations. So, the board can make certain regulations by undergoing a certain process. So, what is the process? First of all, the board has to get a prior approval of the government. So, in order to get the approval of the government, it has to notify it in the official gazette. After the notification is done in the official gazette, within 30 days or so, it has to be placed before the parliament. And once it is presented in the parliament, both houses of the parliament will have to approve it or will have to modify it. So, from this process, that is under the section 58, the process is defined, and from section 58, it is clear that the board cannot sua motu direct the governor to do something, but will have to undergo such a long process. That is, it has to get the consent from the government through publishing it in the official gazette, and after it is published or within 30 days, it has to get an approval from both houses of the parliament. It can be either an approval or a modification. So, all this process has to be completed before placing some regulations on the governor or directing the governor to act accordingly. So, it is clear that the board doesn't have an overriding power over the governor, or it is a difficult process. The Central Board of Directors is a very important current affair. You should be able to know the role and functions of the Central Board of Directors. You should also be able to know Section 7 of the RBI Act and what is the ongoing tussle between government and the RBI. You can find the PDF of this lecture on my Facebook page, and for any queries related to your UPSC preparations, you can get in touch with me on my Facebook page. Thank you, and I wish you all a very good day.